Project status reporting is one method of addressing the importance of project communication. Its purpose is to effectively and efficiently communicate project status at regular intervals to project stakeholders. So in this slide, I'm going to show you how to make a project progress slide. And this is how the slide looks. When I click, it will tell me the progress so far. It says 75% completed, and then how many stages we have completed and how many stages are yet to start. So let's see how to do this in PowerPoint. Add a new slide, go to view, enable the guides, go to insert, shapes, under rectangles, select rectangle rounded corners, draw this much size, and then you can see the small orange point, just drag it inside so it becomes fully curved. And then I'm going to just reduce the size to this much, and shape outline, make it no outline, and gradient and fill, you make it some gray color, and then say align center, align middle. Then I'm going to select this shape again, press Ctrl D to duplicate, and I'm going to reduce the width from this one. You can just reduce it. Maybe I need this much. And for this, I'm going to fill some dark colors onto it. So once you have added the color, just place it exactly here. And then I can simply go and remove the guides. Now I want to give this animation to this bar. For that, go to animations, enable the animation pane, select this bar and add animation, go to more entrance effects, and I'm going to select stretch and say okay, and effect options, say from left, so you can see it's coming from left, and double click and timings, make it medium and say okay. So you can see here slowly it comes there. So we have completed the project this much far. Assume that this is maybe a 70%. So I'm just going to highlight that, go to insert, shapes, select a line, draw a straight small line here, exactly here, and shape outline, go to dashes and select this one, which is dash lines, and then go to insert, shapes, select the rounded corner rectangle again, make it fully curved, reduce the size, and put it exactly in the center, shape fill the same color, or you can just take some lighter colors, shape outline, make it no outline, and I'm saying completed here. Completed. You can reduce the size, make it bold also, and then you can put the percentage. For example, I'm saying that okay, this is 70% completed. Make it bold, make it bigger, and put it exactly here. Now I'm just going to put the stages, how many stages we have completed. So for that, go to insert, shapes, select the oval shape and just click it here. And then you can shape fill with some good colors. You can select shape outline, make it white. And if you want, you can make it somewhat the weight increase also. And then reduce the size by holding the shift key and put it here. Still, we can reduce the size. And then either you can add the icon there or you can just add the number one, stage number one. And then I'm just going to add more details here. The title is stage one. And then let me just change the font, make it bold, And I'm going to add some detailed text here. For this stage, again, I'm going to change the font to Century Gothic. Reduce the size. If you want, you can make it center align. And exactly put it here. Now I'm going to copy these three, highlighting these three. Or you can just select one by one by holding the Control key like this. And Control D to duplicate and put it here one, which is your stage two. And then you're going to put it here, say the stage three, and then stage four, and last is stage five. Then you can come and change the color of your choice. And these stages I'm going to fill with gray color so that we know that still the work is pending. And let me just change this one to two, sorry. Two, and this is three, four, and five. And below also you need to change it. Two, three, four, and five. Right. Now you can see here the design is ready. Now it's time to do the animation. We have added just one animation only for this bar. Now I'm going to start with this line. And I'm going to use only one animation, which is called the fly in. So let me just click on the fly in. Fly instead of bottom, I'll just say flying from top, and this should happen say after previous. Then this also fly in again from top, and this also fly in from top again. And this I'm going to make it with previous, but I will delay a little bit of 0.25 seconds. And this also with previous 0.25 seconds delay. And then when I just click here, play all, it will do something like this. Comes one after the other. You can see it comes one after the another. Once this is done, you can just do the same thing. Now I'm going to do for this again fly in. So this is from the bottom. And if you want, you can keep it on click if you want to control the slide, or if you want to show all once, then you need to just go and say after previous. And then I will say this one again fly in, this also fly in. So I'm just going to select the second animation, which is the stage one, and I will just say this also with previous a delay. Again, this also with previous, and there's a delay. If I play, it will work like this. You can see it comes one after the another. And this, I'm not going to do the animations again. I'm just going to copy the animations. To copy the animations, first select the object from where you want to copy the animation. I will select this. I'll click on Animation Painter, and on which object or shape you want to copy this. So I'm going to copy to the stage two. So it happens. So you don't need to do again and again. So I'm just going to copy one by one the animation. So let me just do this one fast. So this is the last one now. That's it. So let's play now how it looks. So it comes the bar, then the percentage, and then the stages comes one by one. So you can see here presenting the project status is very easy now. That's it from me, friends. Thank you for watching my YouTube channel, and don't forget to subscribe to PowerPoint University. See you soon with more interesting stuff. Till then, goodbye.